Hello everyone and welcome to Sources Classes. So in this video again we've come up with a question pertaining to the ones that we see in the test of mathematics. So what we'll do is basically we'll try to identify the questions that are being asked in this kind of examination, and also we'll take a look at the ideal approach towards tackling these questions as well. So having said that, let's take a look at the question at hand over here. The equation x cube y plus xy cube plus xy equal to 0 represents, so again we'll not go with any prior conception about the kind of equation itself, and will simply represent the equation given here in its simplest form to get a general idea of what can be the actual thing behind the same. Okay, so we have the equation. So let me take x, y as common. Okay, so we'll have x plus y plus 1 equal to 0 on x, y, y square and y square. Okay, so here this term cannot be 0. Because the minimum, this term cannot be equal to 0, because the minimum value for the following term would be simply 0 plus 0 plus 1 equal to 1. So this term has to be x squared plus y squared plus 1. It has to be greater than 0, and the minimum value of the same will simply be 1. So therefore, xy has to be equal to 0, right? Xy has to be equal to 0 because 0 comma 0 can be written. So therefore what we have over here is that the initial condition is xy is 0 and x square plus y square is always plus 1 is always greater than 0. So if we take a look at the same, so what we have is that x into y equal to 0, so this is nothing. So if x equal to 0, y equal to 0, so if x is anything 0, so this is just the origin. This is simply the origin, because x, y equal to 0 is nothing but the origin over here. So it will simply mean x equal to 0 and y equal to 0 at this particular point. So and if we take a look at this, if we put x equal to 0, y equal to 0, so since they intersect the point, so they will meet, we'll simply have 0 plus 0 plus 1 greater than 0. So this is nothing but the coordinate axis, that's it. So this is nothing but a pair of straight lines, just a diagrammatical representation, equational representation of the same. So I hope this is clear to you. This was a fairly simple question. All we needed to do was identify which part of the question was zero, and in regards to that, simply give us a value, that being x and y equal to x and y equal to zero, equal to zero, and this will be coordinate x-axis. So for a simple fact, I'll give you, say x squared plus y squared is greater than equal to minus 1. Okay. So if x is 0, y square is greater than minus 1, and if y is 0, x square is greater than minus 1. Okay. So anywhere in this is there are no real values would be obtained, because x, y would simply be greater than or equal to minus 1, and x would be also greater than or equal to minus 1. So it's just the coordinate axis that we have. So in case you like, make sure you go through the video in case you're having any difficulty in trying to understand the thing, so that you can go through this as many times as you feel comfortable enough to understand the concept and try to solve this question on your own, just by keeping the video as a reference only. So if you like the video, make sure to like, share and subscribe to our channel so that we can keep coming up with relevant content such as this further down the line as well. And having said that, I'd like to sign off. Thank you so much.